तीर्थंकर महावीर यूनिवर्सिटी में ऑब्स्टेट्रिक्स एंड गायनोकोलॉजी की ओर से सीएमई कम वर्कशॉप फर्टीमेड 2019 का आयोजन किया गया, जिसमें मुख्य अतिथि के रूप में MOOGS की फाउंडर प्रेसिडेंट डॉक्टर नीना मोहन, IMA यूपी स्टेट इलेक्शन ऑफिसर डॉक्टर राजेश सिंह, IFS के बेस्ट यूपी के सचिव डॉक्टर जेके गोयल, अहमदाबाद से आई डॉक्टर कांति बंसल, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग चेयरपर्सन डॉक्टर रेहाना नजमा, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर पूनम सिंह, एडिशनल डीन एकेडमिक्स डॉक्टर नजमल हुडा, डायरेक्टर प्लानिंग हॉस्पिटल श्री विपिन जैन जी ने संयुक्त रूप से माँ सरस्वती के समक्ष दीप प्रज्वलित करके वर्कशॉप का शुभारंभ किया। इस मौके पर अतिथियों को प्रतीक चिन्ह भी भेंट किए गए। डॉक्टर नीना मोहन ने बोला कि श्री सुरेश जैन जी ने मुरादाबाद को जो मेडिकल हॉस्पिटल की सौगात दी है वह किसी वरदान से कम नहीं है। मरीजों को अब दिल्ली या अन्य जगह इलाज के लिए जाने की आवश्यकता नहीं है।
Probably you have heard my lecture downstairs or not, that we are now doing, whatever we are doing is outside the body and that is in vitro. We are not doing in vivo. So when we are doing in vitro, we have to be very sure that we maintain the similar environment or borders given in our body. So now, we are, first of all, when we receive the semen sample, at a lab, we can receive 10 samples, 15 samples or 50 samples or 100 samples. So we have to properly demarcate that this patient belongs to this patient. And if we miss that particular moment, then we mix up everything. And when we mix up everything, we will end up in a different progeny of the family. And that is crime. So that is very important as a student, as a technician, or as a lab personnel, that we should, the moment before the sample is given, we should mark it. So that we don't have to rewrite on the sample container. And as I told you, the semen sample containers are all mouse embryo tested, so they are non-toxic. And we generally advise them to collect the sample inside the hospital premises. Unless the patient is not able to procure the sample inside the hospital for certain reasons, then we ask them to go for counseling. So counselors will be also able to explain to them. You can also call other people, so what happens like this. Have you understood that counseling is very important? So we reassure the patient that there is nothing wrong with you as a male. You will be able to give sample. We try and give them some stimulant drugs also. Probably we give them time also and room and ambience also to get the samples at the hospital. Because if we take the samples at home, then he is more liberal, he may not be able to do a proper sterile techniques at home. So first of all, before we explain to the patient for procuring a semen, he should have 72 hours of abstinence. Abstinence, you know everything. That they should not have intercourse for last 72 hours. So we get a sample of 72 hours. Now second thing is that how we have to maintain, we have to explain to the patient that how he should give the samples to us. Now, mostly these patients who are coming are infertility, are already under a lot of stress, so they may not be able to give you a large quantity. So we are getting whatever samples they give. Now we ask them to clean their organ with the soap and water, then clean it with the towel. So everything is, whatever the proper cleaning is there, that can be cleaned before giving the sample. Now once we ask them to masturbate, and then procure the sample. Okay, once the sample, before the sample itself, we have already given the name and whatever the hospital data is there, barcode is there, we have already given. Now, the sample is should be given in the hospital or in the pathology lab or the place within 15 minutes for procurement. Okay, now the sample comes to the place with the naming and everything. We keep them at a place. But one thing is very important, that these sperms are not that much temperature sensitive as oocytes are. Okay? Even the God has given the spermatogenesis in our body, male body, in the testicles. And the testicles are outside the body. Why they are outside the body? Because the body temperature is 37. But the testicular temperature is 36 or 35. because they found that the God has found that the spermatogenesis occurs at a little lower temperature, not at 37. So that's why the testes which were there during the fetal life inside the child, the fetus, has come down in the testicle, in the scrotal sacs. So sperms are more sturdy. They can sustain a lower temperature, but not very low temperature. So they can be remain at 22 to 36 degrees of temperature. Okay? So we the time when the sample is drawn or procured, we keep them in the room temperature. Room temperature can be anywhere between 22 and 36. This is how the sample is kept. Now second thing, why we keep the samples here? Because the sample also has, because if you see the consistency of semen when it is given at that particular moment, is very thick, it's very viscous. How do you know the viscosity? Is like, you know, when you're making a sugar syrup at home. Sugar syrup for a home is made in a different viscosity. We call one tar, two tar, three tar. Jalebi bana rahe hain, ya koi aur cheez bana rahe hain, ya gevar bana rahe hain, to uske liye alag alag halwai logon ki viscosity hoti hai. One tar, two tar, three tar. But semen sample also has three tar. It's a very, very viscous solution when it is come out from the bottle. So now that is not liquefied. So we allow the sample to get liquefied in passage of time. Now how? Because without doing liquefaction, we cannot examine the sample. You understood this part? To understand the morphology and motility, we require to have this thing. So now we allow the sample. A normal semen sample will get liquefied in 15 to 20 minutes time. See, you can see how it is liquefied. Otherwise, when it is seen, you can, even in your practice, you'll be able to see how viscous the semen is. Now, if the sample is not getting liquefied, because in many infertile patients, the sample doesn't get liquefied. Now, we have to do certain techniques. That's called manually how to liquefy. To show that the technique, how in case, if the sample is still remain viscous after 15 minutes, and we cannot see, we cannot go further.
So dear friends, at the outset, my heartfelt thanks to Professor Rehana and Professor Poonam Singh. Poonam is actually, I think she's one small part of my heart. She is very close to me, and she had this intense desire to have, like, you know, all women have intense desire to have babies. Poonam had the intense desire to have a workshop here in Moradabad so that all the students, she herself, everybody, the department grows and learns doing assisted reproductive technologies in the most correct way.
Presently, this chapter has got around 270 members, and membership drive is continuing. A step toward this goal is to update the knowledge and skill of health professional. This workshop has been organized by Teerthanker Mahaveer University. I am grateful to the organizer and faculty, in particular Dr. Rehana and Dr. Poonam Singh, for holding such a wonderful workshop and CME. I am sure this will be a great academic feast on infertility, giving excellent opportunity to all the participants and to enhance their knowledge to keep abreast with the current advancement and development in the field of infertility. I am confident that all will be benefited immensely, and their investment of time will be fruitful.
वो जो दर्द है, पेन है, कि जिस के घर में एक बच्चा नहीं होता, वो जो पेन है वो वही समझ सकता है, और सोसाइटी के इस पेन को, कम्युनिटी के इस पेन को जो लोग दूर करते हैं, I can say they are like God. This is the noblest work for the society, and also I feel that you, all of you, when leave from here, take a oath कि वी विल डू समथिंग और आई कैन से यू आर एबल टू डेवलप ए सिस्टम बाय विच द पेरेंट्स हु डजंट हैव एनी चाइल्ड हैव टू सक्सेस. तो माई कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन एंड आई एम वेरी ऑप्टिमिस्टिक अबाउट दैट दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस विल हेल्प इन दिस फील्ड. थैंक यू वेरी मच.